Dynasty was the glitzy 80s soap that took catfights to a whole new level. Not even our next guest could avoid the drama.
Adam!
Jeff, be careful!
Adam! What the? Get your hands off me!
What was those lines about?
I don't know what you're talking about!
No, you don't!
Get off!
You're trying to make us look as dirty as you are!
There's nothing between Monica and me.
You've been all over her, even in public.
Whoa.
Get him, Jeff. John James played Jeff Colby for 168 episodes, earning a Golden Globe nomination for his role. We don't know how many tables he broke. And now this star is reuniting with some old castmates from the hit series, taking a trip down memory lane. And to tell us more, John James joins us now from Nashville. John, it's always a pleasure. We love having you on the show, as do our viewers. We spoke with you last year when Dynasty turned 40, and now you're back with some of your cast on tour.
Yes, good morning, Nerelda and Tristan. We about a year ago, in the middle of COVID, I was thinking, what am I going to do? What are we going to do? And might as well use the time. And I'd always have wanted to do a show. So I called Jack Coleman, who played Stephen Carrington, and Gordon Thompson, who played Adam. And that's why I was chuckling when you came to me after that clip, because that's a big segment of our show is our favorite scenes. And frankly, I name a number of them in the show with Gordon, because that's all we did was fight. But so we came up with the show, wrote a number of songs, one of which is Didn't You Used to Be, because frankly, at this point in my life, I get people coming up to me all the time and they'll look at me and they'll say, didn't you used to be? And I'd say, no, I still am. And yes, I was Jeff Cole.
Yes, you still are. And so then Cocktails with the Carringtons was born. Is that something that you have worked with them for a long time? I mean, was the nugget of an idea there all along, do you think?
Well, we created it. We actually asked a friend of mine by the name of Mark Rosano, who's a Broadway producer, to come on board. And I'm in Nashville and Mark is in New York. And Gordon and Jack are in Los Angeles. So for about 4 or 5 months, we did Zoom rehearsals. The show is scripted. And obviously we had to write the song and rehearse those. And then we recorded it in a recording studio in Los Angeles last December. And our first show, we opened in Palm Springs in December. And people love it. It's a fun show, and people just really dig the show. And this funny video, when you said, what are you doing? And I said, well, I'm going to give you an exclusive, because we just put the video up on YouTube last week, and you can find it at Cocktails with the Carringtons.
So great.
We most definitely YouTube. Do that. Well, I think as fans of anything like this, we love the behind-the-scenes view from this series, especially first-hand accounts of it. Obviously, fans can expect that, but could we expect to see you guys down in Australia soon with it?
Well, right now we're investigating. Funny enough, in the UK, there's interest of us doing the show in the UK this summer, this coming summer, and also in Belgrade, Yugoslavia. I was shooting a film there last November. They are actually reshooting the entire Dynasty scene. They licensed every episode. And we were filming at a location where they had been the previous week. And it was being used as one of the scenes in the Dynasty segment. And our production manager said, would you like to meet the young actor who plays Jeff Colby? So he came out to this set with the girl who plays, the actress who plays Fallon. And it was so odd to see this young actor playing the role I created nearly 40 years ago. And there he was in Belgrade, Serbia, shooting Dynasty again. So, yeah, we have interest. And I want to go to Australia because I'd like, first of all, to say hi to my niece, Lori, and her husband, Mario, and her two lovely children, Grace and Max, and all of my other family down in Melbourne.
Oh, that's beautiful.
John, Dynasty played to a weekly audience of over 50 million fans. A lot of the fans were in Australia as well. The cliffhanger from season 5, it's still talked about today. It's absolute classic. Very, very dramatic. At what point did you realise the show was becoming a classic? And did you know that it was having huge success in Australia?
Well, we knew just about everywhere in the world. That's part of our show. We talk about each of us relive an experience that we have overseas. And I'm not going to tell you what they are because I don't give away the show. But yeah, it was incredible. It was incredible. I mean, Gordon's story about going to Finland, mine going to Africa, and Jack going to Italy. I guess you could probably say it's like the heist or something like that, money heist today worldwide. But you have to remember, we were canceled. We were canceled with an audience of 29 million people. Oof. 29 million people. I think the biggest show in the United States today would get half that. Now, granted, there were only 3 networks at the time, and cable was just in its infancy, and certainly there was no internet. But we had a tremendous audience just in the United States. And around the world, I think we played in 70 countries, I believe. Yeah.
Wow.
Incredible.
Oh, and also, it's funny, in Belgrade, or in Serbia, I just found an article in the LA Times where the Communist Party at the time was trying to get Dynasty off the air because it was just immoral and it was not the communist thing to do when they were communist. But a fellow told me that in Belgrade, now, this is before you could record anything, Monday night, he said, the streets would be empty. And that was true. That was true a lot with the show because you had to rush home, watch the show, or you'd miss it.
John James, Jeff Colby,
yes,
is with us now to answer some viewer questions. They've been coming in thick and fast. First off, Luke, huge fan. He says, what do you think of the new version of Dynasty?
I don't. I've only seen the first show, and I haven't watched it, so I really can't comment on it.
Okay.
I'm not a fan.
All right. Okay. Scott asks, were you disappointed when Dynasty ended, or were you ready to move on?
Oh, I was very disappointed. One of the stories in the show is I remember standing at my dressing room door, turning and saying goodbye to my suit because I knew it was over, and I'd been that character for 10 years.
Oh, well, yeah. Helen, John, wanted to know, do you have a favourite Australian actor you have worked with or would like to work with?
Probably Mel Gibson. I mean, Mad Max, my generation, great actor. I'd say Mel Gibson.
Good stuff. And tell me this. You said before you're always getting that didn't you used to be. Can you tell us who you are going to be? I've heard that you might be playing Joe Biden in a new project.
Yes, I am. I'm playing Joe Biden in the upcoming feature film My Son Hunter. And it's co-starring. The funny story is that I had to go to Palm Springs right after this, and I couldn't do the show with my hair white like that. So I went from Joe Biden to Ronald Reagan to Donald Trump with my hair color. It just wouldn't take. But yes, it's coming out next year. A very, very interesting film directed by the actor Robert Davi. People who might know him, and Lawrence Fox is playing my son, and I'm looking forward to it. I think it's going to be quite the movie.
Sounds amazing. John, we saw some of those action sequences from Dynasty in the 80s. Did you do some of those stunts yourself?
I did them all.
You did all your stunts?
I did them all. Yeah, only occasionally, and that was... I did them all. Gordon and I did all of our stunts together. We had a great stunt coordinator. I can't believe it. Maybe that's why I have all these aches and pains now.
How many coffee tables is that then? and glass and champagne flutes on the head.
Oh my goodness.
And it all looked so intense all the time, but who for you was the funniest cast member on set?
Oh, I'd have to say Jack Coleman. Jack Coleman, who played Stephen Carrington, has just a tremendous wit about him. And I used to love working with Jack because we would always crack each other up. Jack Coleman, by far, probably had the best sense of humour of the cast.
That is fantastic and great to hear. What a pleasure it's been to speak to you. Yeah. You can catch Cocktails with the Carringtons on YouTube. Again, John, thank you so much for joining us. It's always a pleasure getting to speak to you.
Well, thank you very much, guys. And call me next year because something good will happen.
We will for
John
sure.
John James, an absolute legend.